Piper goes on to discuss praying to the triune God, and he admits, of course, what is obvious to all of us, that prayer is offered mainly to the Father. There is some prayer offered to Jesus, that's true. But then he goes on to make the extraordinary statement that it's right to pray to the Holy Spirit. There's no such example in the New Testament. The Holy Spirit is never worshipped, never sends greetings. As you know, the greetings come from the Father and the Son, never from the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is not worshipped or prayed to, not once in Scripture. So the fact that the New Testament doesn't ever refer to the triune God as three in one, never ever uses the word God to define a triune God, surely ought to sound warning bells all around the Christian world, suggesting, as it strongly does, that the triune God, the Trinity, is a post-biblical development under the influence of Greek philosophy and should be discarded if we believe in following the command of Jesus to accept the Shema of Israel, as in Mark 12:29 he did. And of course, remembering that in John's epistle, he says, he who departs from the teaching of Jesus has a relationship with neither the Father nor the Son. The teaching of Jesus is all important. And there it is, right in Mark's Gospel in chapter 12. An absolute affirmation of the Jewish Hebrew Bible definition of God as a single person.